from Refined Fitness Studio, back with you here, episode number 6. What is your pain? I can tell you right now, it's probably the most frustrating thing that I deal with on a daily basis. Is we hear from so many people that have got a lot of aches and pains, and we're going to talk specifically about some different types of pains. But for a lot of people, it's why they don't actually get started on an exercise program, when in fact, the exercise program is the actual thing that could actually help reduce or better manage that pain. So I really want to talk to you about that today, and why exercise can actually help reduce, better manage, or prevent a lot of the aches and pains that you have. Now, first and foremost, if you've got an undiagnosed ache or pain, you should really always get it checked out with your doctor. Family doctor, physiotherapist, chiropractor, depending on the type of pain or the issue that you've got, one of those three healthcare professionals, medical professionals, really can help you diagnose it. Myself, as a personal trainer, regardless of my background, I've got a certification as an exercise physiologist. That still really doesn't allow me to diagnose injuries or pains for that matter. So first and foremost, we want you to get it diagnosed. And I will also tell you, while I greatly respect the medical profession, one of the most frustrating things in the world for me is when someone from that world will tell their clients not to exercise at all. I just never see that as being the proper solution. There's always the right, I really think it's about finding the right type of exercise. Obviously, we can control the intensity, we can find exercises that don't cause aches or pains, and I definitely understand that sometimes in the short term when we're playing with different medications or when we're waiting to get some tests done, some people may need to hold off on an exercise plan. But more often than not, what I just see is that vicious cycle turning into just it taking longer and longer for someone to get started on an exercise plan. So if it's appropriate, push your doctor a little bit to say, listen, I'd really like to get started on an exercise program. Is it okay if I try it, even at a low intensity, as long as there's no pain? And obviously, if they say absolutely not, then we both have to follow those guidelines. But I think sometimes we err too much on the side of caution when it comes to exercise and a particular health condition. So let's start with a really, really important statistic. 99% of chronic health conditions and diseases can be better managed, prevented, or reduced significantly when someone follows the right exercise program. Think about that. That's an amazing statistic. And that's why really, in my world, we call exercise the miracle medicine. It is that magic pill that can help just about every exercise, just about every condition there is. Now the key is finding the right type of exercise for each person. Doesn't mean everybody gets the right type of exercise. So whether you're suffering from arthritis, diabetes, whether you're getting ready for surgery, and that's what I want to come back to, because we're seeing a lot of people, clientele that we work with going in for surgeries, knee replacements, shoulder replacements, joint surgeries, different things like that, back surgery. We can also talk about exercise's role in cancer, cancer prevention, cancer management, cancer therapy, strokes, any sort of cardiovascular disease, almost number one on the list for high blood pressure, cholesterol. Besides the medication, obviously, we need to get that taken care of in the short term, but in the long term, exercising the right diet is going to get you off those medications oftentimes, not all the time, okay? So, as we're talking about this, remember, it's the right type of exercise. You've got to find the right, what the right fit is for you. I'm going to back up and talk about surgery. No doubt about it, we've seen a dramatic increase in surgeons strongly suggesting their clients get started on an exercise program before they go in for surgery. It helps with two things. One, it makes the surgery much more successful, but equally as important, the recovery after the surgery is significantly reduced. So just think about it. If your health is better, if you're in better shape going in for surgery, you're more likely to recover better, and so you're likely to have a safer surgery. People are going in for bariatric surgery, any sort of weight loss surgery. We're seeing more and more physicians asking people to lose some weight, get in shape before that. We know that is a fact. I've got a couple of examples of clients that are going through cancer right now, and exercise has played a humongous role in the whole, we're not even at the recovery process with the two people I've got in mind, but in the past, it definitely played a role in the recovery process. But during their treatments, And we're not just talking about the physical part of exercise. Obviously, the mental part of exercise. Exercise just plays a critical role. And there is tons of science to back all this up. This isn't me just talking about the clients we deal with on a daily basis. So if you've got a pain out there, and that's the reason why you're not exercising, you need to get up off of your butt and get started on an exercise program. But talk to a professional that can help you find the right exercise program, okay? Talk to a professional that's worked with people with your type of injury, your type of condition, or maybe just your age group, so they know how to tone it down. They know how to modify an exercise program. And it's not all about seeing how hard you can be pushed, because oftentimes that's not the solution. And if you're willing to put up with a few, for lack of a better word, a few bumps in the road, you're going to see a reduction in that pain. I promise you, exercise always, always, always makes it better when it's done in the right way. Okay? So that's one less excuse you've got on your list. I don't care what that pain is, we can help you make it better. Okay? Thanks for listening in this week. Mike Bates from Refined Fitness. Okay, everybody, I've got Beryl Roth here with me today. Beryl is a rather new client. I actually met Beryl a few years ago, and we've reconnected here, and she's just getting started on an exercise program, been going about 3-4 weeks. So, Beryl, tell us about why you got started.
Because I had to do something. I was tired of sitting at home getting flabbier, and I just wanted to tone up and just feel better about myself and get off my ass.
Okay. I think you're allowed to say that. That's okay. What had prevented you from getting started like prior to like 3 weeks ago?
Well, I suffer with angina. I have a plate and 5 screws in my arm, and I just let what I couldn't do influence what I could do. So I came here, and I'm really so happy that I did.
Great. So what, tell me about, and it's only been a few weeks, but tell me what you've noticed, like what kind of changes have you noticed and what did you found out about yourself?
That I'm not as weak as I thought I was. I have more energy. I'm not as tired in the middle of the afternoon. I just feel better about myself. It's just amazing.
Great.
I wish I could put it into words, but it's hard.
Awesome. No, that's good. That's good. So, so you did something, you know, that we love to see, obviously, but so sometimes we do these things called these 1 month trials, and that's actually what you came in and got started on. And you came up to the front desk and you caught me at the front desk after your first week. And you said, Mike, I want to continue. I don't remember the exact conversation, meaning you didn't want to wait till the month was up to make your decision. And me being a bonehead sometimes, I said, oh, don't worry about it, bro. We can wait till the end of the month.
And I said, no, I want to do it right now. Right. This is the best thing I've done for me in a long time.
Right. So it was really nice. So why, like, what connected for you here? Obviously, something was working about, you know, kind of our space and the experience here. What would you say? Could you pinpoint a couple of things that you really like here about Refine?
I love the flexibility of the time that I can come almost any time. The people are amazing. I mean, almost everyone calls you by first name, and that just blows me away. It's quiet. It's not a lot of young things, you know, jumping around, and I just feel really, really comfortable here.
Great. Awesome. Okay. Well, thank you for sharing your experience so far. And again, that's been less than a month, just for the record. So.
Yep.
You got a lot more great things to come. So thanks.
Looking forward to it.
Great.
Okay, everybody. This week's question of the week comes to us from Thelma Pepper. And she's asking if it matters what time of the day you eat your grains or your carbohydrates. Thelma, without a doubt, there is next to no scientific evidence that states there's a better or worse time of the day for you to eat your grains or your carbohydrates. We know a couple things. We know it's great. We know it's ideal if you're spreading your meals out evenly throughout the day and there's regularity and consistency with your eating. We talked in past episodes, we've talked about limiting the number of grains that you're taking in per day unless you're a high performance or a long distance runner, someone who's putting in a lot of kilometers, even a swimmer for that matter. But for the average person, females in particular, a couple grains per day is about the maximum we normally like to see them taking in. Now, you get carbohydrates from lots of other sources. We're talking about grains in particular there. So it absolutely does not matter what time of day you eat your grains. Now, individually, if you just find you feel better having them at certain times, go for it. That's totally up to you. But in general, we want to see your food spread out evenly throughout the day. Okay? We're seeing our questions drop off here this past week. So hopefully, that's not a sign of your disinterest in what we're doing here. Please post some more questions. We've got a handful more left to answer. I love talking about this kind of stuff. All you need to do, go out on Facebook, or you can reply to the emails that we send out and just let us know what you're thinking. Even if you're struggling with something, it doesn't always have to be a question. Just say, you know, I've been struggling with this, or what's the best way to do this, or anything along those lines. Those are the common questions that people've got. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to start coming up with questions, and I'd much rather you guys come up with them than me. Okay, so those are your questions of the week. This week's winner of 2 free personal training sessions is one of our great longtime clients who's seen amazing results, Mary Kay Savage. So Mary Kay, congratulations. You've got 2 personal training sessions. You can email me to let me know when you'd like to redeem those, and we'll put them on your account. Thanks for all your help promoting Refine TV. Mike Bates from Refine Fitness Studio. Thanks for checking in, and we'll see you next week. Bye.